Hi students, this is the 12th session of corporate communication in which we are going to discuss about promotional mix. So I believe we have come across with lots of offer when we go for buying anything at a store or somewhere. So like you have come across with buy one, get one free, 10% off, 20% off or something like that. So these offers are one example of your promotion, right? This is not only, this is one example, only one part of sales promotion. Now, if we define sales promotion, promotion has been defined as the coordination of all the seller initiated efforts. They just have concentrate on the words seller initiated efforts to set up channel of information and persuasion in order to sell goods and services or to promote an idea. So whatever effort a seller takes, whatever initiative a seller takes to convince the buyers to buy anything, to set up multiple channels through which it can inform others or it can persuade their audience, their buyers, so that the buyers become convinced and buy those products. So all kind of such efforts, such initiatives will fall under this promotion. So the main function of promotion is number one, to inform, number two, to persuade and influence the consumer's buying decision. So if we talk about mix, promotional mix, so promotional mix is a subset of the marketing mix in which marketers attempt to achieve the optimal blending. Optimal blending means most suitable blending, most suitable mix of the elements of personal and non-personal selling to achieve promotional objectives. So this word mix means there are multiple components. If you talk about mix like marketing mix, so marketing mix, we have 4 P's or 7 P's or 8 P's, whatever. So similar, there are elements. So here also in promotion, there are basically there are 6 elements, and we use the combination, the blending of these elements, and all these elements fall either of personal or non-personal selling techniques. So just have this, have a look on this this image. So these are the 6 elements of promotion mix: advertising, sales promotion, publicity, personal selling, direct marketing, and interactive media, internet marketing. So in the coming sessions, we will go deep inside each component. We will discuss in detail about advertising. We will discuss in detail about sales promotion. What are the tools and techniques of sales promotion, publicity, personal selling? So we will go in depth. So just here a brief introduction. Personal selling means person-to-person communication. So it is a process of face-to-face or person-to-person communication between a salesperson and the prospect, or you can say prospective customer. So in this personal selling, the seller understands the needs and requirements of the buyer, the customers, and try to offer a solution which can satisfy those needs. Yeah. If consumers get satisfaction, or if consumers perceive value, perceive satisfaction, then he can buy that product or service. So this is personal selling. So So in nutshell, personal selling means face to face communication, face to face. So whenever you go to a shop, the salesperson try to convince you to buy their items, like it can be an automobile, right? Like it can be a fridge, like it can be a television, whatever. So you go to any shop, they will ask, they will try to first understand what kind of items you need, what is your budget, and they will discuss about their offerings. They will talk about the advantages, the features, the benefits to convince. So it is face to face. It is a very old promotional method. So here it is all about the skill of the salesperson. If the salesperson is skilled enough, experienced enough, he or she can be quickly able to understand the need and requirement of the buyer. So a salesperson must be a good psychologist as well. So this is the oldest form of sales promotion, personal selling, right? Now we are coming to direct marketing. Direct marketing means simply without reaching to the audience without using any intermediary. So company is sending communication directly through emails, through letters, through reply card, through telemarketing, through mobile or any channel. So that is the gist of the direct marketing. So the reaching customers directly without using any intermediary. Now I'm coming to public relation or publicity. Public relation means we are trying to improve or manage positive public image. Unless you hold a very positive public positive image in the eyes of your audience, your audience are not going to accept you. So good public relation is very important. So it can include the activities through which we can maintain our public relation. Can be corporate advertising, can be conducting seminars or posting some good stuff as publication, also lobbying with charitable lobbying and also charitable donations, some CSR activities. So all these things are going to project a good image about the organization among the target audience or the concerned public. So this is public relation. Now there is a difference between public relation and publicity. Publicity means you don't have to pay. So newspaper wallahs or media is going to cover you, cover your whatever your actions, whatever you have done, and they are going to talk about these things through their media. So a newspaper come, Times of India has covered, you have done a CSR activity at some place, so you have distributed food items, you have distributed vaccines, you have distributed something, you have helped flood victims as your CSR activity. Newspaper have covered it and they have published it. That this company has done these things. So this is kind of publicity. For that, organizations don't have to pay anything. For public relation, you have to pay. For advertisements, you have to pay. But for publicity, you don't have to pay. So when other people will cover you as a news, when other people will cover you as a story, when other people, other media covers you as an article or shares some kind of information. So this is an example of publicity. So it creates public awareness and also they command higher credibility because people perceive that organization has not paid. So if some newspaper company has published such thing, about this company, so definitely it is true. It is worth believing. So it commands higher credibility. Now, sales promotion, as I told you in the beginning of the sessions, you can find lot of buy one get one free, or you can find point of sales materials which can be very attractive, which can be very appealing. So there can be price discount, there can be vouchers, loyalty programs. There may be many tools through which we can influence our consumers, influence or persuade our consumers. So, but one very important thing is that sales promotion is a short-term tactics. So we can't use this technique for all the time. This is just for a specific period. You can run one campaign, one sales promotion campaign for, say, for example, at Navaratra, at some other festival or something. Also, there are some sales promotion campaigns which can run throughout the year, like your loyalty programs. So these are retention programs. So retention program can run throughout the year. But apart from those, if any particular discounts, off season discounts or something. So these are for a specific period only. Then advertising. So advertising can be defined as any creative, non-personal form of paid communication. So one, it should be paid. These are the characteristics of advertising. It should be paid. It is non-personal, means we are going to use mass media. It should be creative. So it is a concept of communicating a message about goods, services, ideas, organizations, persons, etc. to a customer or target audience. So advertising is done using various media like television, print, radio, outdoor, online, digital, whatever. So also there is another way of advertising, that is through product placement. So products are placed in a picture or in a serial. So marketers, they pay the motion picture owner or a TV producer for displaying the product prominently in the program, in the film, in the show. So in the movie you can find a focus on certain brand. So camera is focusing on certain brand, or the hero, actor or actress is using a certain brand. So this is known as product placement. Now internet marketing, so this is a form of digital marketing. So we can use multiple digital platforms. Also, there are multiple ways through which we can use for sales promotion. So it is a very broad term. We can use for search engine optimization can be used. Email marketing can be used. Social media marketing can be used. We can display our advertisements through Google advertisements, Google ads. So all these things are there. Thank you very much.